वेलकम बैक टू चैनल। एंड यू नो वी आर इन हाई एवेलेबल आर्किटेक्चर मॉडल्स। इन द प्रीवियस सेशन वी हैव लुक्ड इनटू डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ लोड बैलेंसर एंड वी नो देर इज फोर टाइप्स ऑफ लोड बैलेंसर इनसाइड AWS। क्लासिक लोड बैलेंसर, एप्लीकेशन लोड बैलेंसर, नेटवर्क लोड बैलेंसर एंड गेटवे लोड बैलेंसर। And we looked into what are the difference between these load balancers and when we should use which type of load balancer. Today we are going to do hands-on lab, so let's get started. So friends, to do that, first of all, what we are going to do, we are going to create a EC2 instance, and there we will install Nginx. Okay, then we will create a classic load balancer. Okay, and we also create application load balancers. Okay, and there I will show you some differences. So from your certification perspective, okay, you need to know, okay, when you should use application load balancer and network load balancer instead of classic load balancer. Okay, to understand that, we are going to create classic load balancer and we will also create application load balancer. Okay, so first of all, let's launch a EC2 instance, and you see I am in the EC2 dashboard, so we need to click it here, and this is nothing new for you. Okay, so I'm going to select this AMI, the instance configuration. I need one instance, and it's going to enable a public IP address. That's perfectly fine. And here in user data, I'm going to put some code. Okay, and this code is for installing Nginx. Okay, so I'm going to put this code inside the description, so you can get it from there. Let's go to the storage. It's coming by default with 8 GB. That's fine. Let's go to the tag is not needed now. And here I have already created a 2 security group. Okay, one security group for the web server and another for the ELB. This looks like ELF, so not, this is for ELB. Okay, let's select this, and here you see I have opened a port 22 from the internet, so that's not recommended, but just for demo purpose I've used this. I have also opened port 80 from internet, that's we need for the testing purpose. Okay, so here now let's launch. We need to select the key I have selected. Let's launch it. Okay, and it's going to take around 1 minute 30 seconds to 1 minute. Okay, meantime it's getting launched. Okay, let me explain what we have in this script. Okay, so here we see this is the bash script. Okay, here I have added 3 important lines. Okay, and this rest of lines you can get from the internet. Okay, but here you see here I have added this line. What this line is going to do, this is going to logs every command what we are going to run in this bash script in var log user data dot logs. Okay, so if due to some reason if this script will fail, okay, we can go and see the logs why this is not running. And friends, this is very important. Okay, so there could be some reason, okay, this script would not run, it will fail, maybe there is no internet connection, there is no public IP address, it's not able to connect with the internet gateway, NAT gateway, anything. Okay, so for that we need to make sure we can see the logs later. Okay, for debugging purpose. Apart from this, I have also put sleep for the 10 seconds, so instance will get time, okay, before executing our command. Now let's go back to the dashboard, and here we see this is running. Okay, and here we see we have the public IP address of this instance, correct? So if you get this public IP and if you go to the browser, mostly we will be able to see here Nginx is running. It can't connect. Okay, it can't connect. Let me retry again. HTTP. So sometimes what happens when we type any IP, by default it takes HTTPS. Okay, but looks like it's not working currently. Okay, now it's good time for us to debug it. Okay, so what we are going to do, we are going to connect here and let's copy this and let's go to the terminal. Okay, and here I'm in the download folder where I have this key. Let's enter the hit. And now we are okay. What is saying? You are not okay. I need to go to the download folder. Now let's run this again. It was not able to find the key. Now you see we are inside our EC2 instance. Okay. Now let's check if this installation was executed correctly. Okay, so we know here is our log file. So let's copy it. Let's go to the terminal and do this. Looks like its installation has started correctly. And here it's located. Okay. Now here we see there was some error completed when it was running this command. Okay. It's saying a non option. See, we have this Nginx is running. Friends, there was a small problem. Okay, so let me go to the script. Okay, somehow this was not running. Actually, what I have done, I haven't practiced before this hands-on lab. Okay, I copied it from somewhere. So what I have done now, instead of this, okay, I've used these two lines. Okay, these three lines, these lines. Okay, and apart from this, I have used this remaining one. Okay, so now our new set of command is this one, and now you see it is running here. Okay, and friends, purpose was here, okay, to show you how you debug, okay, your bash user data script. Okay, anyways, now if we go here and we see it's running. Okay, Nginx is running now. Now let's go and create, okay, it's also running. Now let's go and create a load balancer. So here we see we don't have any load balancer. Okay, so when you click here, create load balancer, here we see couple of options. Okay, here we see application load balancer, network load balancer, gateway load balancer, and classic load balancer. And this is looks like fade out. Okay, so basically, as I said, now AWS is promoting to use the application network load balancer, ELB v2 or gateway load balancer instead of classic load balancer. But in your exam, still you will see question with classic load balancer. Okay, so now let's create classic load balancer, and here we need to give name. So let's call it classic ELB. Okay, and create LB inside this VPC. This is internal node, this is public load balancer, and here we are going to use HTTP protocol. Okay, for the listener. Now let's go to the security group, and as I said already, I have created security group. Okay, where I have allowed port 80 from internet. Now here you see, here is saying, okay, if your traffic to the load balancer need to be secure, use either HTTPS or SSL. Friends, this is very important point. Here you see we are receiving traffic from internet on HTTP. Okay, and this is not secure. That's why it's complaining. What will happen if you go back here? Okay, here if we select HTTPS, okay, now we go to the security group, select this. Now if you go here, you see here it's asking to provide us certificate details. Okay, so friends, what it will do, it will encrypt our all data on transit. Okay, and this certificate we can get from ACM. Okay, free of cost from the AWS if we have the public domain. But this is very important point again for your certification. But here we don't want to do that. Okay, let's change this to HTTP. Okay, and security is fine. So though it's complaining, not a problem. Now here we need to select where our ELB checks health of our application, right? And this is very important feature of ELB, we know, right? So before sending traffic to ELB, it checks health. If instance or application is healthy, then only it send traffic, right? So here we are saying HTTP on port 80, and let's make it on root, okay? And here a couple of more information, response timeout, okay? So in how many seconds, okay, if it weren't healthy, then it will time out. So it's 5 seconds. How frequently, interval, how frequently it will check the health, okay? It's 30 seconds, is quite a good time, but here let's make it little bit smaller for quickly make sure it is healthy, okay? So it's complaining, health check interval must be integer between 5 to 300 seconds. So make it 5, okay? Unhealthy threshold count, it means if consecutive 2 times it will be unhealthy response, then it will mark this instance as a unhealthy, okay? Same for the healthy threshold, okay? If it, this is 10, but we can also make it 2, okay? So continuous 2 times, if it will see your application is healthy, then it will mark as a healthy instance, okay? Now go to the add instances, and here we have option to add instance, okay? So we have one running instance, we will add it, and tag is not needed, review and create, and now it's got created successfully. Okay friends, so here couple of things we need to know. Here we see in a description we have DNS name, okay? So DNS name, now this is we are going to use to access our EC2 instance. If you go and put it here and try to access it is saying it cannot reach. Let me make it HTTP instead of HTTPS, and this cannot reach. It's perfectly fine, right? Now what we can do, we can go in the health check, okay? We see health check is fine. If you go in instances, here we see, okay, this instance is out of service, okay? And here is saying instance registration is still in progress. Friends, again here this status is very important for your certification, okay? Currently we see this is in progress and it will take some time, so this status will change, okay, from out of time to the healthy, okay? And this Elastic Load Balancer V2, it's also say immediately this is initializing, okay? But here it's saying it's out of service. Let's refresh it and it will take time, right? Now we see this is in service. Now load balancer checks the health and it says, yeah, this is healthy, that's why we are saying it is in service, okay? Now again, if you go and try to hit this load balancer endpoint, then we see this is healthy. So you can see here, right? Now we are accessing it with the ELB endpoint. Now let's go to here, okay? And here, okay, if you remember in last session I have said in the classic load balancer we don't have concept of the target, right? Now if we go and try to create application load balancer, in application load balancer there is concept of called target group, okay? Before we go there, let's not delete it, okay? So let's create load balancer, and if you go here, see application load balancer, you can click here. Now let's try to fill this information, okay? Now let's call it app ELB, okay? Of course we need internet facing, and listener we want HTTP on port 80, okay? And this is only VPC, and let's select this, okay? And we don't need a global accelerator, and go to the security group, okay? Now security group, let's select ELB security group and configure routing. And this is where we need to create target group, okay? If you remember in classic load balancer directly we added instance, okay? But here we need to create a target group, okay? So you are going to create a new target group, okay? And here we need to give. So let's call app elbsg, okay? And target type could be IP, sorry, instance IPM lambda function. For us, let it be the instance, okay? Protocol is HTTP and port 80, we know, okay? And again, here we have the health check, okay? So health check, we know it's HTTP, okay? On at the root path, okay? Now register target. And here we see we have one instance running in this subnet. So we need to add this, okay? And now let's review and create. Now it's created successfully. Now if you go here in target group, now here we see we have target group which we have created, okay? So let's bring it here, and here we have the, all this information of the target group, okay? Now here we see we have the instance in target instance, and this status is healthy, okay? So this is very important point. So if sometime if your instance is not running, what we could do, we now here we need to come in the target group, and here we will see what is status of the instance health check, okay? If there should be any error, anything wrong, we can see the message over here, okay? Okay, now to access application through ELB, we will go to the application ELB, and here we will copy this DNS, okay? Again, let me bring it back and let's change this and paste. Now we see with application ELB, we are able to access, okay, we see app ELB, we are able to access the application, okay? Okay, so here, friends, I wanted to show you, okay, how do we create a ELB, okay? How it looks like from the dashboard, what are the different options, and more important things inside the, what are the difference between classic and application load balancer, okay? So we have seen the difference of the target group, right? Another important things, if you go here, in application load balancer, we see we have the listener, okay? And in this listener, we can add different rules, okay? So you see, for the HTTP port 80, we are sending request on this target group, okay? And here we can add another rule, okay? And we can create another target group. If you want some traffic based on the different conditions, right? We know those conditions. IP, host name, HTTP header, HTTP protocol, we can send traffic on the different target group, okay? So here we see, if you click on listener, okay, here you see HTTP port 80, HTTPS, then here, okay? So based on different rule, okay, we can add rule here, okay? Actions, okay? Forward, redirect, okay? Let's say, if you want to add forwards, okay? So we can add different rules here, okay? So this feature is only available in application load balancer, okay? And these are not available in classic load balancer. So based on different conditions, we can send, okay? We can reroute our traffic to different target group. And this is very important. And you will see directly question inside your exam, okay? So friends, that's all for today. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye for now. See you in next session. Bye bye.